Human papillomavirus, abbreviated as HPV, is the most common sexually transmitted infection. In the United States, around 79 million people have HPV, and doctors diagnose around 14 million new cases every year. There are different types of HPV, and some can increase the risk of cancer. Each year, around 19,400 females and 12,100 males in the US develop cancers that stem from HPV. In this video, we will learn what HPV is, how it spreads, the symptoms it causes, and their treatments. We will also explore HPV vaccines and other ways to protect against the infection. There are more than 200 types of human papillomavirus. About 40 kinds can infect your genital area as well as your mouth and throat. These kinds of HPV are spread during sexual contact. Other types of HPV cause common warts, like hand warts and plantar warts on the feet, but these aren't sexually transmitted. Genital HPV infections are very, very common. Most people with HPV have no symptoms and feel totally fine, so they usually don't even know they're infected. Most genital HPV infections aren't harmful at all and go away on their own, but some kinds of HPV can lead to genital warts or certain types of cancer. Two types of HPV, type 6 and 11, cause most cases of genital warts. Warts are no fun, but they're considered low-risk HPV because they won't lead to cancer or other serious health problems. At least a dozen types of HPV can sometimes lead to cancer, though two in particular. Type 16 and 18 lead to the majority of cancer cases. These are called high-risk HPV. Cervical cancer is most commonly linked to HPV, but HPV can also cause cancer in your vulva, vagina, penis, anus, mouth, and throat. HPV is easily spread from sexual skin-to-skin contact with someone who has it. You get it when your genitals touch someone else's genitals or mouth and throat. In most cases, your body's immune system defeats an HPV infection before it creates warts. When warts do appear, they vary in appearance depending on which kind of HPV is involved. Genital warts. These appear as flat lesions, small cauliflower-like bumps, or tiny stem-like protrusions. In women, genital warts appear mostly on the vulva but can also occur near the anus, on the cervix, or in the vagina. In men, genital warts appear on the penis and scrotum, or around the anus. Genital warts rarely cause discomfort or pain, though they may itch or feel tender. Common warts. Common warts appear as rough, raised bumps and usually occur on the hands and fingers. In most cases, common warts are simply unsightly, but they can also be painful or susceptible to injury or bleeding. Plantar warts. Plantar warts are hard, grainy growths that usually appear on the heels or balls of your feet. These warts might cause discomfort. Flat warts. Flat warts are flat-topped and slightly raised lesions. They can appear anywhere, but children usually get them on the face, and men tend to get them in the beard area. Women tend to get them on the legs. HPV infections are common. Risk factors for HPV infection include age. Common warts occur mostly in children. Genital warts occur most often in adolescents and young adults. Weakened immune systems. People who have weakened immune systems are at greater risk of HPV infections. Immune systems can be weakened by HIV/AIDS or by immune system suppressing drugs used after organ transplants. Damaged skin. Areas of skin that have been punctured or opened are more prone to develop common warts. Personal contact. Touching someone's warts or not wearing protection before contacting surfaces that have been exposed to HPV, such as public showers or swimming pools, might increase your risk of HPV infection. The easiest ways to prevent HPV is to practice safe sex. In addition, the Gardasil 9 vaccine is available for the prevention of genital warts and cancers caused by HPV. The vaccine can protect against 9 types of HPV known to be associated with either cancer or genital warts. The CDC recommends the HPV vaccine for boys and girls ages 11 or 12. 2 doses of the vaccine are given at least 6 months apart. Women and men ages 15 to 26 can also get vaccinated on a 3-dose schedule. Additionally, people between the ages of 27 and 45 who haven't been previously vaccinated for HPV are now eligible for vaccination with Gardasil 9. Most cases of HPV go away on their own, so there is no treatment for the infection itself. Instead, Your doctor will likely want to have you come in for repeat testing in a year to see if the HPV infection persists and if any subtle changes have developed that need further follow-up. If you like this video, please give us thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe our channel for more medical videos.